Hello, Paparazzi, and welcome to our ongoing training of Paparazzi Premier Training. I'm Jeff, and with me is AQ. And today is for you Android users. So you love custom fonts. You love settings upon settings upon settings. Well, we're here for you today because the app works wonderfully in Android, but the user interface is in certain screens is just a little bit different than what we've been showing. And so we're going to dive right in and show you the screens and how they work and what's different, but it all functions the same. So I'll turn the time over here to AQ. There you go.
All right, guys. So as Jeff said, it is slightly different. In the tech space, it's called feature parity. Everything works the same behavior-wise. It's just where you see your buttons and all of that is going to be slightly different from all the trainings that we've done so far. So I'm not going to be going back through every single training and trying to squeeze it into this. I'm really going to be focusing on some key areas where there are noticeable differences in how an Android works versus an Apple. So in all the past trainings, I was using an iPad. In today's training, I am using a Galaxy Tab. I think it's the A7 that I'm using. So know that if you are an Android user and you don't like how small your phone device looks, it works great on a Galaxy Tab as well. And that's how I use it too. I'm personally an Android lover, so I naturally gravitate to that. So I'm going to go ahead and get started here on my tablet. It is in my handy dandy little tablet stand. So get yourself one of those. You're going to thank me for that. But let's go ahead and get started here in settings. So I'm already in settings. And the first thing that I want to highlight to you that is different is in how you're going to share your online store link. So on Apple, it's over on the right hand side and it has like a little copy button. But on the Android device, you see the little share icon there to the left hand side and it pops up here. Sorry, it pops up here with your native share features that Android supports. So if you just simply want to copy the link, you're just going to use that copy URL functionality. And then you can go and paste it into a chat. You can paste it onto your Facebook page. You can paste it anywhere you want to paste it from. So that's the first one that I want to highlight to you guys. So now I'm going to navigate over to our inventory section where there are more noticeable differences here. So I'm going to click the menu button. Menu is the exact same. It looks like a hamburger button. So we go here to inventory. And this is where you're going to start to see some of those differences in how the page looks. So the first noticeable difference here is your location of search versus ad, right? So when I was talking through inventory, I think last week, we talked about that the plus sign indicates ad and the barcode icon indicates searching. So your ad button is down here at the bottom. The pink button says plus sign. That's how you're going to search for an item. And you're also going to notice here that there are no grid lines like it does in the Apple device. There isn't a grid line. So you're just going to bring it up to the camera. And there you go. It's that simple. So I'm going to add 3 item number. Bin 2, and you have the same functionality here as add, means you're just adding that one and you want to go back to inventory. Add and scan is your continual scanning feature. So I'm going to click add and scan. Oh, and I'm going to turn it the right way. See how it detected the wrong item number there because I wasn't holding it right. So this one's fun because of how the barcode is being a little bit messed up because of the ring in the background. So because it's, oh, we picked it up. There it goes. But what I want to go back and show you guys this also. So it wasn't scanning. So down here at the bottom, I have manually enter barcode. And I have that ability that I could just key in the same way that I do on my Apple device. So I'm going to use the scan functionality real quick and get these added here. Love how that scan is so easy. It really makes it. Simple. Oh, that was me again. Not being still with my hands here. There we go. Say we got three of those. There we go. So now I have those three pieces from Fashion Fix in my inventory. So same thing where I was saying the add and scan features, that plus sign button. Well, search is now still at the top with that barcode icon. So the icons are generally the same. It is just the placement that's different. So when in doubt, just look at the screen and say, is there a plus sign? Is there a scan icon? And that's how you're going to know the difference there. So one of the other noticeable differences here is your incrementing and decrementing. So plus sign is increment, minus sign is decrement. So if I needed to say I'm going to, this item is damaged. So I'm going to take one out and I'm going to click save. You see here, the difference here is that this is now a pop-up modal versus on the Apple device, it swipes up from the bottom. So we're going to say damaged and it takes it away. So that is your inventory screens on how you will see the differences. So there's one final place where you're going to really notice difference, and that's on your orders when you're placing orders and sending invoices. So I'm going to go ahead and navigate over to orders. And you can see here, it does default exactly the same way. We're on open orders. It's showing me all. So I am going to add, see the plus sign down at the bottom. Let me go back and show you just real quick because I did that really quick. I want to make sure everybody sees it. Down in the bottom right-hand corner there is the plus sign, whereas in Apple, it is in the top. So we are going to click the plus sign. We're going to create this order for Jeff. And now here's another noticeable difference on this screen. You have the plus sign over here on the left for add items, right? So if I just wanted to find the item this way, I could do that. But your scan button over here in the top right-hand corner. So we are going to send this item. Here, sorry guys, this is, my hands are shaking. Naturally a shaky person. There we go. So now it adds it. So the other noticeable difference that you see here is that our toggles for ship order and consultant cost reimbursement are flip-flopped. Whereas on the Apple, it's consultant cost reimbursement and in, it's on the top. So we are going to ship this order and let's give Jeff free shipping. So you see the behavior is still the same. It's just the placement is different. And we do want to collect back my consultant costs. So that's how we're going to do that. So the final difference that I want to highlight is that when you click send invoice, instead of a slide up, for seeing copy link versus send email, this pops it up in a new window. So you have copy on the left, send email on the right, and the behaviors are still the exact same behaviors. So that's on creating a new order. So the final thing that I want to show you the difference on is for Android is when you need to go back and edit an order. So we're going to go back to that order and you're going to see it looks exactly like this. So my edit button is over here on the top left-hand side. It's not a it's not a button down at the bottom like it is in Apple. So I'm gonna click edit. It brings it right back into that same edit mode. And we are going to add this one, just like that. So those are the noticeable differences between Apple and Android. I can't emphasize this enough. The behaviors are exactly the same. They work exactly the same. It's just the placement of your buttons that are going to be different. So when in doubt, just look at the page and see where it is. It may not be a one-to-one match on your Apple trainings, but the features are definitely there. So that's that. That's how you know that it's all feature parity in your Android devices.
Nice. There you go. And as always, make sure you have the latest update. I think another update pushed yesterday.
Yeah.
So make sure you have the current update as well so that your screens look like these screens. And we love you Android users. There you go. And as always, if you need any help at all, our support team is here. They're doing a great job helping everybody through this. And so don't hesitate to reach out. We appreciate our Premier team too. And we hope these videos are helpful. And we hope you have a great day. And we'll see you later.